Hi everybody, welcome back to another tutorial. Today I'll be going through some texturing again. This time we'll be creating a cliff face in a bit of a cartoon style. So you can see I've just added a few little elements in there, some plants and some rocks from some previous assets I've created before. Now we're going to take a look at the model really quickly. And it's literally just a very quick way, using the EP curve tool, I just created a curve outline that looks like that. And then I just used a planar modifier and then extruded it up. And down below I've actually deleted the faces down there because we won't be using that. I just want to keep it as clean as possible. So I've extruded it up maybe 3 times. You can add a few more and just increase or decrease the sizes just to make it a little bit different. And then UV mapping it is actually quite simple, just the top UV map and then the sides. So from here we'll take it into Photoshop and we'll start with just the basic shadows. And before I do go on, I do want to point out that the shapes look a little bit like scales, kind of like that, just a bit of triangles. The only exception is you kind of want to be really rough and jagged whenever you're painting the shadows in. So just painting in some very quick shapes, trying to get them to look relatively good, and it doesn't look like much initially as always, but once you get into the mid-tones, then the entire cliff texture really starts to take shape. So this is a very quick method. The next part is to find a good mid-tone, so I've just created a new layer, and using the mid-tones, what I've done is I've painted over the shadows to create these small little cracks. And it's important to be really rough and jagged whenever you're painting those edges, because you want them to be just to resemble rock as much as possible. And it's just a simple matter of painting the edges and then filling it in. And this is probably the part where it would take the longest, so don't fret if it takes you a while. This actually took me about 10 minutes. Yes, it is pretty tedious, but it's worth it if you go in and do it really carefully, like I did here. Sometimes you get a little bit impatient, you just want to rush it, and I mean, just try not to rush it too much, because you do want to get this particular segment right. And once you do get it right, you can already see that the cliff face is starting to really take shape. Now the reason why I'm using a very dark shadow is because I want this to have a very cartoony appearance, or a very cartoony texture to it. And I've based this reference in a lot of comic strips, just looking at how the shades work. It's not exactly like comic strips, but it's just finding the values and seeing how it works. And once you've done the mid-tones, you can already literally see that we've done only 2 layers. So we've just done a shadow or line art in there, and then we've gone over with the mid-tones on top. So it's really quick. So after that, now we can use the highlight tool. But first we're going to go and do the shadows first, because again, it's just better to start with shadows than to work on highlights. So make sure you have your preserve transparency on, or lock transparent pixels on. It's just on the top left side of the layers tab. And it just makes painting in the shadows really easy. It just means you won't be creating new colors on top of transparent pixels. So it will just only paint over where there already is information. And after I've done the shadows, I've just gone to a deeper shadow color and just painted in more shadows just to define it a little bit better. Again, you don't have to be super accurate. As long as you're using a noisy brush, you can get a really nice rock effect with that. And then after that, I've just started painting on top of that once more using the highlights, and I just want it to be very, very subtle. Most digital painters will have added some extra hue to the shadow colors, probably like a slight blue. In the case of textures like this, I actually don't want to do that, because a lot of the lighting is going to change inside a 3D scene. After we've done with that, we just added a quick burn effect. I just created a new layer and added the effect on top. And then I'm going to work on the cap, or the top segment of the cliff, just by simply drawing in some contours. Like I said, this isn't a realistic texture. This is just a very cartoonish kind of style that I'm going for. And if you want to add more detail, you're certainly free to do that. Obviously, it's just going to take more time, but just for the sake of time, I've decided to do this as fast as possible, just to do some very basic shapes, just so that you can get an idea of what to do during your painting. So after that's done, I've just added some extra shadows and dirtied up the top ground, and it's pretty much there. So it's a wonderful way of doing some digital painting, guys. It's definitely just something you can practice and get better over time. And once you're done, I'm just going to bring it back into Maya. And that's pretty much your cliff complete. So feel free to add some extra little doodads like I did. I've put some plants and rocks on top. The comparison's a little bit different in this particular case. I've done the rocks a little bit larger than normal. So using just the Lego technique, I just duplicate, rotate, scale, just to give the cliff a little bit of an edge, make it a little bit different and, you know, variable. And that's pretty much it, guys. Hope you like this tutorial. If you have any feedback, comments, criticisms, leave them in the comments section. I'll do my best to try and be consistent with more tutorials down the track. So there you guys have it. I'll see you guys next time.